Hey guys, Snipereye 2010 here again. This time around, I want to talk about two apocalyptic shooters that just came out here recently. Far Cry New Dawn and Metro Exodus. And I'm going to go between the two of them and tell you why I believe Metro Exodus is the better of the two games. Now, in Far Cry New Dawn, it ends up following the story of Far Cry 5 where, spoiler alert, at the end of the game, nukes are dropped on Hope County, Montana. And in Far Cry New Dawn, the survivors who took place in shelters, they come up from above ground and try to make a new society. And this time around, they're facing a new enemy called the Highwaymen, led by twin sisters. Versus Metro Exodus, it's the third year of Artyom's adventure in Moscow, Russia. This time around, he's exploring a lot more above the metro, trying to follow a mysterious source that he's hearing on the radio. And he's starting to wonder if there's more life outside of Moscow and outside the metro itself, and possibly if the above ground is actually becoming livable again between all the pockets of radiation. Now, that's where the similarities between the two games end. Far Cry New Dawn feels more like an action-adventure shooter, versus Metro Exodus is definitely more of a survival horror shooter. Far Cry New Dawn, it's the same gameplay mechanics as Far Cry 5, it's just a brand new story, and I believe that's why they went with the $40 price tag. Versus Metro Exodus, it's definitely similar, but in many ways much more different from the previous two games. This time around, Artyom is exploring Moscow and outside of it throughout the rest of the country, Russia, on a train called the Aurora. Now, he's starting to discover there's more life out there beyond the metro, and in it, in the game, there are multiple maps that you get to explore, and the game has a lot of survival elements in there, mainly dealing with your weapons. This time around, not only do you have to scavenge for materials in order to keep your weapons up to date and get new attachments for them, the ammo when you play through the higher difficulties is very limited, and most of the time you end up having to craft it. Plus, here's the one thing I did not see coming, and that's maintaining your weapons. They gain dirt and grime over them as time goes on, and as you use them more and you fall through the mud, and if they are not properly taken care of, eventually they'll start to jam on. Between the two games, it definitely has a horror aspect to it as well, and a full day and night cycle. During the day, you have to deal with more bandits and a lot more radicals and enemies of the human kind. And throughout all of it, there are mutants, but during the nighttime, you also have to face electrical demons, as they call them, and many other enemies. Between the two of them, Metro Exodus has definitely caught my attention, and I also love this one as well. When you play through the game, there are many choices you can make that will affect each game's outcome, each map's outcome, and it's definitely got a lot of replayability to it. Between the two of them, Metro's definitely coming out on top in my opinion, but I want to hear what you guys have to think. Please, let me know in the comments below. Between the two games, are you going to be playing more Metro Exodus, more Far Cry New Dawn? Do you maybe like both games, neither one? Let me know. I want to hear what you guys have to say about these two games. And if you like this video, please give it a like and give the channel a subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. But until next time, this is Snipereye 2010, signing off.